All right, hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to the channel, Keyshay's Creations. Thank you for joining in with me today. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome back to all the former subscribers, and welcome to all the new subscribers, and welcome to those of you who are just stopping by for a quick view. Once again, thank you all for joining in with me today. As you see from the title of the video, we're going to go ahead and dive into this beautiful monthly energy reading for our dear Libras. Before we do, y'all should go without saying, please check the description box for any information that you may want or need to know, and if you have any questions, do not hesitate to let me know. As it states in the description box, these readings are intended to be timeless. Time and energy are fluid, meaning you could have already gone through this, you may currently be going through this, and or this may be a prophetic message to come if you decide to embrace and embody the energy or advice that Spirit has for you within the reading. Please keep in mind that they are general. Not all may apply to you, and that's perfectly okay. Take what does, let the rest fly. It may be a message for someone else. I may not even be talking to you nor about you. I may be talking to or about someone to whom you're closely connected, friend, family, or foe. I do not know your life. So please don't force that shoe to fit if it doesn't, Libra. I am not responsible for your feet, your toes, nor them currents hurting, all right? Because you're forcing something that wasn't even intended for you in the first place. We also don't subscribe to gender roles over here. However, you will hear me say, likely hear me say, he and or she in reference to masculine and or feminine energies, which we all have both within us, all right? So roles may be reversed. Flip-flop yourself as you need to. Once again, apply where it lies, otherwise let it fly. I am big on numerology, whether or not I call it out, but if and when I do, I intend for it to likely resonate with your life path number, the day and or month that you're born, potentially the house that you may want to pay particular attention to within your natal chart, whatever, what have you, all right? Now, typically in the past, I have had it set up as to be read past, present, future, and to my fellow readers out there, you may want to continue to read it as such. It really does not matter. Like I just said, time and energy are fluid. I have switched it up just slightly to where this is intended to be the potential current energy. This is the potential energy to come in the very near future. And then this is the advice, okay? We are also utilizing a new deck. If you haven't checked out the unboxing of this deck just yet, which it is the Medicine Heart Oracle by Elena Fairchild, I highly recommend that you do so. I'm loving it. It's giving us some beautiful messages. And I'm excited to see what it has to tell you today, okay? Or whenever you catch this. It's clarified by the Golden Wheel or Tarot of the Golden Wheel, which all decks will be listed below for your reference if you so choose, all right? Now, before we go any further, let's just get a quick word of prayer before we get into it, okay? To the Most High, Heavenly and Divine, Angels, Ancestors, Spirit Guides, I come to you saying thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for this beautiful day and opportunity. Thank you once again for using me as a clear and open channel and humble vessel to bring forth the messages straight and clear to the collective, no chaser. Thank you. Thank you for the love and support, most importantly. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for the gift of tongue, for the gift of reason, insight, awareness, clarity, mental stability. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for protection. Speaking of protection, I pray that you block, bind, unwind, cut cords, simply transmute any low-vibe negative energies or entities coming in to try to steal, kill, and or destroy or cause any hurt, harm, or danger, and or even try to keep us stuck, stagnant, and or confused. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your help. I pray as always that the message uplifts, enlightens, heals, strengthens, protects, nurtures, nourishes, encourages, just bring forth whatever the viewer may need and may it play out in their lives for any and all involved for the utmost and highest good, as I know you will see fit. All these blessings I come ask and give thanks yet again. Ashe, 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 oh. All right, my beautiful Libra. So, interestingly enough, I really don't have any like channeled messages for you, which is pretty strange yet powerful at the same time, because your energy has shown up in every single last reading thus far, and it's something big about that. So it's like there's a sign and message in everything, right? and for me not to really have any, not even a song, like, not even, well, I was hesitating on the numerological message because collectively everybody has been getting something having to do with 1221, 2112, or even 212 potentially. And so I do feel like something big is either occurring during your season on 1221, even 212, you know, December 21st, or even February 12th and or 21st, to be honest. And or it's like that span of time, either from the 12th to the 21st of whatever month, to be honest, but especially February and December, like I said, or vice versa, from the 21st to the 12th. So that really can be whenever, you know what I'm saying? But it is something big with those numbers and that energy. And even in, like, as I was in meditation and pulling your cards, y'all see how it is right here, right? I feel like somebody is stuck in limbo in regards to something, or like maybe the illusion, maybe moving forward, maybe even like what it is you're receiving from insight, or, you know what I'm saying, enlightenment, or there's a need to really take the time, definitely a need for balance, because it's funny how you got three may be a number for you that are on its side, essentially, you know, kind of like the scales, which, you know, you embody potentially if you are balanced. But I just feel like there's a need to, because whether or not these were intended to be upright or reverse, that really doesn't matter to me. Y'all should know by now. If you don't, I read the energy no matter what, no matter if it comes upright or reverse. So it really doesn't matter. But when it comes sideways, it's goodness, it's interesting because, you know, that, again, that tells me that somebody is, again, in limbo or don't know which way to go, right? Need to balance themselves out to even get it upright, because typically you want to see it upright depending on the card or energy you're talking about, right? Anyhow, that's really what it is. And I'm sure some songs and, of course, other numerology will come out for you in within the reading. I mean, you already see you got 19, 27, 16, and 13. And, of course, with the moon energy being 18, you can use those numbers as you will. You may have been born on any one of these days in whatever month. I was going to say November. Who was that for? Anyway, because I don't even know where that came from. But especially, what we got? January, February, March, April. What else? June, July. Double confirmation even with July, because we got 2, 7, 16 is potentially a 7, right? I was going to say, oh yeah, August, because we got the 8 and the 18. September, of course, that's you, you know, even October, because 19 potentially is a 10 and or a 1. Lots of 1s I'm noticing. So yeah, did I cover them all? And then, like I said, December too, for whoever that. So even odd, whatever month. Obviously, because like I said, you done showed up in every single last reading, and I won't be surprised. I'm not yet done. We almost there. But I won't be surprised that you show up in the rest of them as well. So you may want to check them out, or whichever energies call to you the most throughout your reading. Those may be the ones you want to focus on, okay? Because when I channel y'all, I'm generally channeling for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North, and or South Node, but it can be anywhere in your chart, or you have Libra or whatever other energies jump out to you, okay? All right, so without further ado, let's go ahead and get into this, because I got to be mindful of our time, because I don't want it to cut out on us. And I swear, all this throat clearing and stuff don't occur until I literally repress. Listen, somebody is repressing that. And I was just getting ready to say, somebody need to work with their throat chakra, because it don't start until I press record. And it has been a heavy overall emphasis. I mean, you obviously are air sign energy, but it has been a thing too of speaking up, like standing in your truth and speaking your authenticity, and working with the throat chakra to do so, okay? All right. Moving into your potential current energy, we have the number 27 in the cicada Christ, and I forget who this came out for, but we went deep down up and through there. I want to say maybe Cancer, don't give me the line, or even Leo. Regardless, y'all, the energy of the cicada Christ brings me all-out heart transformation. The cicada is a sacred species, and y'all know it's very unique. When you hear that sound, you know what it is, because it's a sound like no other, right? The fact that it's at Christ's heart chakra is amazing, because that speaks to me of transformation, shape-shifting even. I love the fact that that I know this. I told the other sign too, whoever it came out for, that this is the mid-body and the head, but together they look like a crown to me. And so somebody's being adorned. Maybe somebody I heard adore as well. Somebody adores you, your beautiful heart, or you them. Okay, this is screaming balance to me. So even four may be significant, because that is the heart chakra. Plus, he has, it's actually four, but at first when I first saw this card, I only thought it was two on you know, each shoulder, or, you know, one on each shoulder, but only two. But then you notice that it continues. It's almost like a necklace or a wrap or whatever. But that's the four-leaf clover. So four may be very important to someone. And then this is giving me sweet grass or even spider plant behind him. So you may want to work with that plant, you know what I'm saying? And it's like some sap that I feel is falling off of it. So I'm hearing Erykah Badu again. How good it is. How good it is. What she say? How good God is. So yeah, and understand, I don't want to go all deep in that tangent that I went on last time, but you know what I'm saying, your history, as far as when I did the unboxing, I don't too much care for, you know, the depiction of Christ, because if Jesus Christ is who they say he is in the Bible and comes from where he comes from, he is supposed to be a melanated man with woolly locks, okay? And but like, regardless, it's the energy, okay? It's the energy of enlightenment, of truth seeking, of being a healer, a shaman, medicine, whatever term you want to put to that. But being that beacon of light and being balanced and grounded in your own energy. 27 potentially being a 9 talks about that solo dolo, like it's personal, right? I know I told you these readings are not personal, but I'm saying it doesn't have to do with anybody else but you, okay? and that's heavy emphasis on somebody being, especially if somebody's born in September on the 2nd, 7th, and or 9th, or even 27th, which is your leading into your season and energy, right? So, and as you see, I don't, you know, you take it as, I just see a crown of enlightenment, but that could even be moon energy. So it could be, somebody could be Virgo moon, heavy, even Libra moon. Yeah, there's something in here for you. So let's go ahead and get into what Cicada Christ is trying to tell us, okay? So I got to do it like this, because this is how they came out. First out, we have a 3 of Swords. What is this heartbreak? What is it that you're not trying to see? Look how she got, sit there right here. Look how she got, she is like in turmoil here. Has been, if this is past energy for you. I do feel like this is your energy or coming into your energy. The number 3 may very well be important to someone. It's the need for the heart healing. That's what they said. It's the need for the transformation out of this. I heard lack for whatever reason, but I feel like it's like just talking about lack of love, or the thought, the feeling like, or thinking that you are not loved or you are not balanced within your heart chakra. Because this lends to the 4 of Swords, which is definitely all about your energy for me. And that's my R&R, which is that rest, recovery, rejuvenation, and repeat. Healing, so much healing energy is needed here. Come out of the darkness, come out of your mind, Libra. Balance your mind, right? Like I said, get into that Virgo energy and your energy of separating yourself, being in that solo dolo energy, hermit energy, and seeking, looking deep within you to see where this heartache and pain is coming from and to heal it. Now, when this came out, this was supposed to, well, I shouldn't say it like that. It came out how it came out, but like y'all saw how it was. It was intended to be the second card of this column here, but it flipped out just like you saw it right on top of this. So I feel like it's meant, and it came on its side too. So I feel like it's intended to cross it. And like I said, this Page of Cups can keep showing up. And it's talking about, like I've told everybody that it's came out for, that needing to give yourself that love, fill your own cup up, and apologize to yourself for maybe even allowing yourself to be in this energy as long as you may have, or as long as you find yourself, right? This comes after the 10, specifically the 10 of Cups. So it's like any of the pages I've been telling y'all, because it comes after the 10, it signifies to me that you have completed some cycle in whatever element it is. This is particularly the Cups. So it's something very emotional that you have, obviously, with this Three of Swords, which is, you know, like I said, that heartache and pain. But it's something that you may have been attached to. And I feel like more so mentally, but especially, how I need to say that, more so mentally, but as well as emotionally, obviously, with these Cups out here. It could be anything, anybody, any place, to be honest. But it's like, forgive yourself for where, maybe even the illusion, like I said, just the thought, just because your mental space is what creates your reality, and the energy you put towards whatever thought form is, you know what I'm saying, you are maybe even going around and around about, that shapes your reality. So if you don't want to be in the dark any longer, it's time to release that. You see that wolf? Like, get out and howl at the moon, especially if and when the moon is in Virgo and or Libra. Something about, I don't know, any of the other signs to be that, for that matter, but especially that, because that's what's coming through right here. All right. Obviously, that's water sign energy. Like I said, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. So it may even, and with the moon over here, that's, to me, that's heavy Cancerian energy, but it still could be Pisces or Scorpio. So even when the moon is in either one of those signs, you may want to, you know, get out and release this. Okay. Next up, the Eight of Wands. See, that's definitely that stuck energy, because Eight of Wands went upright. It's fast, quick, fast, in a hurry. It may be fast communication, fast movement, whatever, what have you. It's also with the Eight, potential abundance in whichever you're talking about, communication or movement or whatever manifestations you are trying to bring into fruition, you know, pretty rapidly. It's talking about that as well, but it's stagnant. Something is stagnant, and I feel like these won't really, the ones that are sideways won't necessarily turn upright, or you won't alchemize the energy to transform that or transmute that until you go through this heart transformation. Yep. Somebody may be trying to get through to you, and it could be somebody who, you know what I'm saying, who you dealt with in the past, who has I'm trying to be careful on how I say it, because I don't like to give outside influences any credit whatsoever, because it really, the power lies within you. Only you can allow something, someone, or someplace to make you feel any kind of way, whatever. You are in charge of your emotions, of how you feel, what you think, what you do, blase, what you even say, right, with the communication, the air energy. So it's like, God, somebody really need to clear their throat chakra and speak up for what you want, how you feel, what you see. And that could just be you speaking to spirit, like going to your altar, to your throne, and just releasing all of that pent-up energy, releasing your heart, speaking on your heart's desires. Put it out there, y'all. That's the only way. I mean, I'm just saying, that's how you manifest. That really is. You can't hold on. I mean, you can, but it ain't gonna do nothing but cause stress, anxiety, worry, and literally some heart issues if you're not careful, right? The stress, that's the silent killer. High blood pressure, which can lead to so many other things down the line. My God, my God. I swear, y'all, hey, somebody better do something with their pro chakra. Like I said, get out, howl, sing your song, do something. Don't just sit there. Ooh, see, you gotta get out. I feel like this is self-deception, Libra. I was about to call you Leo. Some of y'all may have been dealing with a Leo. This is self-deception. Because it's like backwards. I mean, ain't no right or wrong way, but look how it's facing compared to the way these came out on its side. It's facing the past, right? And it's like somebody may have been trying to get out, sneak out of a sticky situation and may not even known how to move, you know what I'm saying? You are love. Come through, Cleo. Even if you don't love yourself, that's what it is. Mm-hmm. Somebody may have been in that illusion of feeling unloved, right? Feeling that heartache and pain. They just wasn't for you, honey. And you probably have given so much of yourself to this situation. You done poured your cup. You know what I'm saying? You done poured from an empty cup for so long. You may even want to check out Virgo because I know I told them that very thing. But it's like, you got to get it to yourself. And the karmic cycles or situations or events, what have you, that you have gone through have simply paved the way for you to see that, for you to realize that, for you to become enlightened as far as how much of you have given to others when you really needed to give it to yourself. And then the excess or the overflow when you fill that cup up from self-love, that is what goes to other people, not the other way around. Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of y'all truly may have dealt with a lying, cheating sack of, you know what I'm saying, sack of shit. Because that's what I get from this Seven of Swords, Three of Swords. Mind you, that is the Ten of Swords. And that is some heavy, ooh, God. That is mental confliction at its finest, but it's ending or needs to, right? Potentially. Because like I just told y'all with the Page of Cups coming off that 10, that needs to be done data, right? Mm-hmm. And you need to move and move quickly. The lightning in the back of this Eight of Wands, I was about to say Eight of Swords, in the back of this Eight of Wands signifies that change and rapidly. You know what I'm saying? Get with it. Somebody, yeah. I feel like spirit is like, man, come on. Yeah, but like, what y'all doing? Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. Because when we get to Lou, she got a whole lot to say. And it's beautiful, though. But it's just like, speaking of, there's a heart. Let me just show you. I really don't be liking a mess with these. Ooh, she Wolf of the South. Somebody made this. Oh, okay. I was just getting ready to say. Didn't I say even something about karmic cycles anyway? South Node typically talks about that. Like, talks about things that for lifetimes you have already gone through. It's like the comfort zone. But it's a need to get out of that comfort zone because some of y'all may have stayed in it too long just because you would rather, what is that crazy? It's like so backwards. Like, don't just stay in hurt or in a situation you know you're not meant to be in because it's comfortable. How? I don't understand how this shit comfortable. But I mean, you know, everybody done been through some type of shit, like, so I'm not judging because I done been there, you know what I'm saying? Been there, done that, and got a few t-shirts to show for the medals to prove that they made it through, right? So glad I made it, right? So glad I made it. So glad I made it through. Because that 10, the air energy, the crown chakra is one of the toughest ones to master and get through. That's why it's at the top. That's why it's the seventh chakra, right? It's that's a lot of spiritual. It's where the spiritual warfare goes down. But anyways, with this, even it's like you have had to learn how to balance your light and dark. Look how they facing off into the black wolf and the white wolf facing off. Like, yeah, what's up? Your higher self, like, ego. Hey, I got you, bro. We're gonna put you in a chokehold. Like, that's probably why you can't really speak. You know, I'm having to clear my throat, but it's like, nah, I need for you to sit down. Sit down and rest a little while. Anyway, but with Lou, I just wanted to show you really quick. She has the heart at her third eye chakra. And you see, it's a little bit like confined, if you will, which mm-hmm. is bringing me back. Mind you, that's the third eye, number three, right? It's not the third chakra, but it's the sixth chakra. But what I'm saying is third eye, three, right? Confirmation here. But it's like, what's been on your mind may have been this, I'm hearing love's got me stuck up in your love cycle. Whatever that, who was that? What's the child name? Oh God, I could see her. What is her name? I'm sorry, honey. And that old boy, y'all know, if I remember, I'll try to put it in here. But it's like, you may have been conflicted in regards to love and not seeing, like I just got through saying about all this, that you had to give it to yourself and all that stuff to come out because, and to free your mind. Because as you see, she's full, it's abundant here, right? This is the deer elk is telling you to ground your thoughts because they got the earth sign symbol at their third eye. So it's like ground yourself in your mind and it brings yourself into your heart space. And that way you can see the loving energy that you need. And that's how you're going to receive that enlightenment, that wisdom and the guidance. Go on how you feel, because even the 19 is the sun energy potentially in the tarot, which is Leo energy, talking about moving and being guided on how you feel. Leo rules the heart shock, well, the heart and the cardiovascular system in that way. So like for real, they want you to embody that energy, okay? Being carefree, being showing and showing up in your royalness, in your regalness, and not being afraid, like really taming ego, because that is even strength energy about taming the beast, you know? Speaking of those wolves. So anyway, let's go ahead and read what Cicada Christ has to say. And I got to watch our time so we don't go over, but page 219, what I tell you about them threes. Prosaic ambitions will not satisfy you. Your heart is capable of grander visions, worthy of your soul. Such magnificent manifestation requires complete transformation as spiritual fuel for actualization. The worthy soul vision awakens such yearning in your heart that you will be willing to overcome all obstacles, all fears, all doubts in order to live it. Told y'all. Your courage attracts divine assistance to protect the path and reveal the way. Your path is assured and you do not have to be afraid. Timing of all things is divine. Even delays are on your side. There's a reason, and that's why these are on its side and in limbo and why you're not moving. That's a delay for you to be able to have the time to sit with yourself and really receive this enlightenment, Libra. I kid you not. I tell you no lies. And that's what it is. You just turn into, I guess you say this, Nongpa, just so we can be ready. All right, so moving into your potential near future energy, we have the number 16, Nongpa. And this is powerful because 16 in the tarot, major arcana, is the tower, scorpionic energy. And that talks about transformation, change. It's coming. I was getting ready to say, ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. The divine is gonna find you. And take it slowly. It may not be too slow for y'all, because the tower can be a quick, fast, and a hurry. Because like, if you've been so stubborn, you know you need to move and get out of this situation, and you are not, or are being defiant or resistant, it's gonna be like boom, and that's when it's really gonna hit you. That's when people, I feel like, be like they don't like the tower, because it'd be like a sudden change you ain't ready for. But it's like they're giving you time to get ready, right? And if you stay ready, you ain't gotta get ready. So it's just like all in what you think and believe. Where is your head at? Because even speaking of head, and you see she's in meditation. I was gonna say this, the same little sappy energy is the same, it's coming from, it's like a carryover for sure. And that's crazy, because it's even in this one, as we're about to get into in just a moment. But speaking of the head and crown, you see, look how that rooster look. And ain't that, that's the male, right? Because the hen is the female. So this could have some, like, you may have some masculine energy on your mind, heavy. And it's like somebody's piercing, because I feel like, I know that's her earring, but I feel like somebody may have that, what do you call that, the gauge. That may be who you're dealing with, or you have that, maybe confirmation. But anyways, I feel like it's the talon of of the rooster piercing through, like trying to get her to listen. Yeah, listen to the sound, the song of her soul, you know what I'm saying, the inner workings, when tapped in and to receive the enlightenment. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what flower this is. I heard orchid, iris, lily. Yeah, but you may want to work with that, but it signifies purifying the thoughts. It's almost like there are two of them. That may be important. So it's even bringing me kind of to the Two of Swords energy, like being kind of stuck in your head as far as trying to decide or not knowing which way to go, which idea to go with, which whatever to choose, because twos talk about choice. The choice is yours, but you got to be able to see it clearly, and you got to be at peace mentally in order to do so, you know? Mm-hmm. Because her hair, it's been a theme too in regards to them being spirit bringing me to like notice the hair on in whatever cards come out, as far as this, you hold power energy, of course, in DNA, right? And it's like something may have been tied up for a long time, right? You may have been going around even in your mind for a while now. I mean, I feel that, I see that, it's here, and it's like it's time for that cycle to end. There's no need for that confliction at all. Time to get rid of those fears, like the Cicada Christ told you, you know? All right. And then when this first came out, I was like, what? I mean, I know that's a bird feeder, right? Birdhouse, whatever. But it's dark. And, you know, birds signify air energy. And speaking of, you may have, because with something, the rooster or even, what is this, blue jays over here? That may be a spirit guide told them for you. But it's like, again, with that air energy, something of the past or that has been keeping you in the dark, in the illusion, that needs to go and be transformed and purified, okay? You got to change your mind, baby. Work on that crown chakra. All right, let's see what Longpa has to say. Ooh, I love it when they do this. What I tell y'all about that Scorpionic energy and that transformation needed? It's coming, whether or not something is ending. This is 13 potentially being a 4, and I feel like the transformation of your heart chakra going back to the Cicada Christ. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Getting out of your head. Because look how even in the skull, which is, to me, signifies like wisdom, enlightenment, as we're about to get into taboo over here as well. But through all of the decay and darkness, this is growing. Some of you, I heard kale. That may be what you need to work with, eat, feed yourself. But some leafy green. Mm-hmm. But it's growing even from, like I said, the decay. You are enlightening even through this mental affliction, right? You got to see that, like you said. Face your fears. All is well. Fear ain't nothing but false evidence appearing real. And that's that devilish low vibe energy meant to keep you stuck, stagnant, and confused, or in the illusion, right? What's that? I love it. Thank you, Spirit. I love you. I love you. I love you. It's everything I just got through saying in Lou. That 19 with the sun energy. This is Leo energy. You taming the beast, baby. You are taming. You are balancing your mind. And because if you do as I'm... a spirit is advising you to get in your heart space and balance yourself, give your, you know, love on yourself, be at peace in your mind. You taming that beast, and like I said with the She-Wolf of the South, your higher self is winning the battle, right? The battlefield is your mind. Love it, I love it, I love it. Come through. This also is the energy of perseverance through it all, but through it all I remember that he loves me and he cares and he'll never put more on me than I can bear. Mm-hmm. Come on, Kirk Franklin. This is all freaking major arcana. Even with the 16 being a tower, this is all major arcana, Libra. And the choice is yours. And somebody truly may be dealing with a lover or some type of loved one. Because it doesn't just have to be romantic, okay? I don't want y'all to get it twisted. Gemini energy here. It's like I said, look, the way this is set up, it's interesting because I get earth energy out, obviously, from that green, but it could just be talking about your heart chakra, fourth chakra, right? And then this is fire sign energy, but because it's red, it could just be talking about your root chakra, which in turn is saying, make the choice to ground yourself within your heart, right? Because the root chakra is the base, is talking about being grounded, solid on what you stand on, what you believe. May have something to do with somebody in your family. You could have been dealing with a snake. You see that snake in the grass? Could be that earth sign who was that or is that for you. Does not have to be, but during any earth sign season that you were dealing with this snake in the grass, having to walk away, let it go, or ground yourself in the self-love and all of that. You had to persevere through this backstabbing energy. Could be the Gemini that I'm talking about. I don't know, whoever it is in your life. But the thing about it is, it's like, this is a major feat. The fact that this is centered, and the fact that, like I said, this is all major arcana, it trumps everything. So I see you moving, growing, developing in a major way. Oh my goodness. Let's go ahead and read what Nangpa has to say. Page 142, which is what, a 7. To heal inner pain, the soul may need to investigate the darkness within. God, I can't make it up. And I love it. I love it. Brought me out of the darkness to the marvelous light. And you don't know how glad I am. Mm-mm. Venturing directly into our suffering can help us understand underlying issues and what will ultimately bring peace. Purposeful descent into suffering to liberate pain is a transitory process. Pain is not a place to permanently dwell, but rather a place to pass through in order to transform one's being and one's life for the better. It can be difficult to find the courage, that's that strength energy too, right? That Leo energy. It can be difficult to find the courage to enter our suffering, and also difficult to find the courage to not become stuck or embittered, right? You are traversing a path that is ultimately leading you towards the light, though it may first lead you through darkness. Stay connected to the instincts that tell you good things are on their way, and do not allow your mind to become clouded by doubt or fear. Oh, I just said that. Allow such thoughts and emotions to pass by, like shifting weather. Stay ready. But I tell you, if you stay ready, you ain't gotta gear it. Come on, spirit. I love y'all. Stay ready and persevere, but keep your experiences in their proper context as a healing journey that will resolve itself. That which was dark shall become light. That which wrought suffering shall become your key to freedom. Be reassured, beloved, for the rising of the light is imminent. I'm telling you, brought me out of the darkness into the marvel of light. And you don't know how glad I am. Somebody gonna be rejoicing for real. Mm-hmm. Celebrate yourself. Celebrate the victories, baby, because you deserve it. Ain't nobody else gonna give it to you like that. And your spirit squad, your ancestors are proud of you. I'm so proud of you. Anyway, moving on to the advice. We have the number 13. Again, double confirmation with the death, which is potentially a 4, talking all about that heart chakra, but we got taboo. And when taboo comes out, y'all already know just the word taboo. This could have been something that nobody wanted you to speak on. Like, and it was heartbreaking for you not to be able to speak the truth, because you are all about the truth. You are the justice, right? You bring facts. But it's like the enlightenment that you are worth, because you be hitting the nail on the target. You be hitting the bullseye. You see that? It's like the cardinal. I believe it's a compass, but to me, it looks like even a bullseye. It can be whatever you want it to be. But look at them three feathers right up there, baby. And I feel like they are peacock feathers. But it's funny that they are like gray. You know what I'm saying? So it's like from the darkness, from the decay, by you getting into alignment with that three energy, you will be able to balance. Look at her face is half and half. Balance the light and the dark within first, especially in your mental space, to be able to display outside of you. And I love it because I don't know what this is, a rope, but it's like something was all like tight, tangled, conflicted, and it's like it's becoming loose, unbound, unwinded, right? Free your mind with this bird over here. Free your mind, and the rest will follow, okay? Mm-hmm. So let's see what Taboo has to tell you, Libra. Yeah, you've been fighting. This is the Wounded Warrior Sage energy, and it's time for you to move. This is talking about that spiritual enlightenment and moving along, continuing along your journey, persevering to the end game, your destination, your fulfillment, your fruition, right? This lends to the Ten of Wands, which is lay them burdens down. I heard, Lord, lay your head on my pillow. Spirit wants you to rest your weary mind, honey. Let go of any hurt, harm, pain, anguish, fear, doubt, what they tell you, all that, let it go. Some of y'all with the Wounded Warrior energy, that brings that healer, right? The guide. You got to give it to yourself first before you can be able to give it to anybody once you fill your own cup, okay? All right. And, yes. I got the victory. I got the victory. Here's your opportunity. Spirit is giving you a whole new world is what I heard. A new opportunity. A solid one. This is your chance to build a new foundation. Didn't I tell y'all, get grounded in your root chakra, right? Grounded in your heart. What is it that you want? How do you see yourself sowing this opportunity into something brand new? I got a new attitude. Heavy on the Taurus energy could be any other earth sign, including Virgo and or Cappy, okay? Does not have to be. Could occur during that season where this opportunity comes through for a brand new beginning, okay? Oh my God, I told y'all, I can't make this shit up. Here it go. In case you didn't believe what I said in the Nangpa, here you go. A change is imminent. It has to. You can't stay here forever. You got things to do, okay? That's just what that is. And I feel like it's just burning them ideations of maybe how you got, because this brings me like an authority or like even government type of building. It could be any kind of, I heard association, but what's the word? Like entity or, you know what I'm saying? Somebody who may have felt like they had authority in your life, or maybe you gave them, you know, you felt like they had that in your life, or you know what I'm saying? You gave your power over to them to even make them think that they had the ruling over your life, whatever. It's burning. It's burning to the ground, honey. It has to. This is an oppressive, what I'm getting with this storyline is that whoever this is or was is an oppressive energy. And ain't no way, they might have had their foot on your neck for me to keep getting choked up and not be able to get the message out, having to keep clearing my throat. They may have had you speechless or like I said, trying to keep you from speaking your true authentic, being authentic and speaking your truth. And it's like, they got to go. And this just could be you and only you. You know, nobody else, but like, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm burning with this Nine of Wands energy. Triple, right? Did I not say another 9? Obviously, we got one in blue, but like, I thought it was another 9 somewhere else. But, anyways, oh, the Cicada Christ. Yeah, that's Virgo energy, enlightenment. It's like that solo dolo energy. You're going to have to get alone, retreat. You know? Mm-hmm. Yep. All right, so let's see what Taboo has to say to you. Page 122, which is a 5. It's time to move. It's time to change. It's time to transform. It says, your authenticity may require that you purposefully disengage from societal convention and the various belief systems of mass consciousness. They give it to me like it is, baby. Create space between you and that which would constrain rather than inspire and motivate your soul to realize and express its truth. Spiritual maturity drives the soul to liberate itself from socially mandated moralities in order to seek and live by heartfelt integrity. Only a soul willing to journey beyond the societal pressure to conform becomes able to experience the sacred and understand the spiritual laws that govern its preservation. Such a soul can then nourish society with its wisdom. Something that cannot occur if the soul is hampered by fearful compulsion to adhere to imposed belief systems. I can't make it up, y'all. There is a great source of spiritual power available to humanity. Access to such potency requires willingness to abandon herd mentality, trust the heart, and live life in alignment with deeper values of the soul and the spiritual laws of the universe. Do not allow fear to confuse or distract you from your soul path. And that is where that moon energy is coming into play. Like I said, from the get-go, the illusion, the doubt, the self-deception, fear, whatever you want to call it. Don't allow that to cloud you, from you receiving this enlightenment and inner as well as understanding of it all, of your power, of your purpose, and the intent that you need to move on, you know what I'm saying, to heal yourself and then thus healing the collective, right? All right, so moving into Lulita, and I already discussed her. I said I was going to wait until later, but you sort of had me jump on into her. So 163, what is it? It's a 10, y'all. Done, died, a doubly confirming, even a 19, 10, and or 1. It's time for the new, baby. It's time to be done with this transformation and move on to this abundance here. The soul journey is a spiritual long game. Though there will be spontaneous spurts of swift progress and rapid healing, recovering, and rising through any difficulties, you are also building a long-lasting legacy of sacred beauty. That's your energy, baby. Venus energy coming through heavy. You are soul making. Value the process and value yourself enough to set boundaries with yourself and others. Such a precious undertaking requires patience for the process. Come on, Sage. Temperance. It requires patience for the process, tending in time. Contentment in the quality of the journey helps sustain and inspire you for the considerable task of generating your most sacred legacy. And they're bringing me back to that sacred cicada energy. Mm-hmm. It's going to take that beautiful transformation of your heart chakra, Libra. And don't worry about how long. Time is an illusion. Time is fluid. Like, take as much time as you need. Be patient. You cannot rush the process. I don't care what you do or how hard you try. Because it will come to a point where spirit gonna set your ass down and make you go through this. It's out here twice. It's big. It's important. You got work to do on you first and foremost. And then so that you can come on with on, you know what I'm saying? Join the tribe, you know? Like, for real. We gotta heal this world. We gotta uplift it. We got some teaching and showing people how it's done to do. You understand what I'm saying? So anyway, that's what I got, Libra, and that's where I'm going to leave it. I pray that it resonates. If it does, you know what to do. For those of you who are new, that means comment your testimonies down below. You never know how this may help someone grow, especially including yourself. And only do that, y'all, if you call to, okay? Whether or not someone comes to mind, please do like, share, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you so very much for doing so. I truly appreciate and love you for that. If you want to join me for any other type of video, please check the playlist on my channel. I hope and pray you find what you're looking for, and I hope and pray to see you there. If not, please take care. I love you and thank you anyway. Until the next one, be easy, y'all. Don't forget your love and light. It truly makes everything all right. Deuces.